Imagine that, it's raining.
Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden, and Charles, you look at this Bears team entering play. They come in just in an absolute free fall, losers of 7 in a row.
And this is where you turn to your best players and look at them and say, can you guide us out of this? We've got to be better than what we've shown.
The calendar has turned to December, and we're in the home stretch now as we're underway in week 13. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. So here are the Bears now for their opening drive. And leading them out there, their 6'5 quarterback.
Okay, I thought there was something to build on in last week's game by his performance. I thought he played fairly well overall. The numbers won't knock your socks off. 2 touchdown passes and an interception. The bottom line, though, they lost.
Yeah.
How does he eliminate that one interception, continue to take care of the ball, and maybe increase the number of times he puts the ball in the end zone with a receiver?
Come out throwing here to start the drive. He'll get that complete to his tight end, Cole Kmet. A good pick up there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Here's a 2nd and 2 now from the 33. Something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease, then bursts through for a solid game.
And able to work about 5 yards out of this as he's taken down up near the 47. Well, Charles, you know, you think about this defense. This week in preparation, you couldn't hide the fact from them that they're facing a team that's lost 7 in a row. You just wonder if they prepare the same way they normally do.
Yeah, that's a great question, because normally that preparation goes into what you do well on defense. What is the best thing that you do going into a game? But in this case, you might want to take all the tendencies and throw them out the window. I would expect them to throw every trick play in the book right out of the gate in order to try and get something established and get things moving.
So the defense able to get off the field here on 3rd down.
And it's one of the goals of the game. They've got to be effective on passing downs. It's one of the few things defenses chart. How did we do on 3rd down? That's a nice start for them in this one. Time of the year for them, hasn't it? You know, it's the season is starting to wind down, got a little bit of a break, but how about the guy calling the signals? He's got to be excited about that, because now he didn't just get a game plan for 1 week, he was able to work on it for 2 weeks. I can't wait to see if they have anything special in store for him today.
That's going to go as a loss of 7, and it'll set a bang for 2nd down. Some time right. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far and brings up 3rd down. next play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. On the move to his left. Now he's going to let it go deep left side. And that will be incomplete. Edwards scared to let it fly, but he falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. Fourth down, here's Presley holding on to punt. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the Bears take over. Chicago works their way back onto the field here for their second drive of the game. In the midst of, well, let's just say a not-so-rosy losing streak. They've got the open week, though, coming up next weekend. So you have to figure this to be a game that they dearly love to have.
Indeed, they have to have this one because that's something positive to take with you when you go away for a few days and it actually releases your mind. If they lose this one, that mindset is cluttered the entire time they're away, and they've got to scramble to get back in sync when they start playing again.
Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end.
And the tight end is certainly a position built to move the chains because they can control space underneath. They've got good hands, then of course they're a dynamic target. But one other thing is they're right in the sight lines of a quarterback on just about every play. And that makes it easier for the quarterback to pick him out and deliver.
That'll be knocked away. It's incomplete.
Receiver coaches preach to their guys all the time. Separation, that's what's going to make the play successful. That time there was very little, and I think they were actually fortunate that it was only knocked away and not intercepted.
Second and 10. So quickly, Charles, what could the offense have done to adjust and account for that?
But what you're hoping is that you figure out and you see and get a clue that maybe there's going to be some pressure.
And they got to him again. T.J. Watt, he's the one to get him, and that is sack number 7 for him on the year.
And he shot in, C.D., like he was out of a cannon from that linebacker position. And even though they had a running back in the backfield, no one could stop him.
Well, you certainly diagnosed that play perfectly because as fast as he got into the backfield, you're exactly right. The running back had no shot to get over and try to protect his quarterback, and a sack resulted.
So Pittsburgh retakes the field for their second offensive possession. And you figure this should be a healthy, arrested, a focused unit, and they're working on a good winning streak. They had the week off last week. This is really a team that should be in top four.
I would agree absolutely with that. What coaches worry about, what organizations worry about, though, is overconfidence. They've been playing so well, and now they've had that extra time off. And we've seen teams come back off the open week and come out flat. So what a lot of good coaches do is they kind of game plan for that with their teams on defense. They may blitz more in the beginning to get them going. On offense, they may go more up tempo. Anything to get them out of lethargy right at the beginning.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. Now a handoff here to his running back. Call it a gain of 3, but not enough to move the sticks. It'll be 3rd and about 4. Run of the first quarter, and Charles, we talked before the game about them needing to establish the run game. They'll be looking for more of that.
And they got to the perimeter, so that tells me that that's part of the game plan of what they want to get done today. So they'll have some complimentary runs running to the inside, but it appears that when they want the big yardage, they think they can get to the outside and make it happen.
8 yards to go on 2nd down. Now they'll
switch it up here and look to throw. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And the Steelers are going to have a first and goal as the tackle is made at about the five. Here we go now on first and goal. They don't give it here to his running back. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Steelers. A great effort there with touchdown.
You have to think really is relishing the opportunity to be on the couch for a few days.
Yeah, they certainly are, but let's face it, partner. They can't get caught looking ahead to that couch time while they're playing this one. They've got to take care of business first.
Cole Kmet, the intended receiver, but it's going to be second down. They'll set up a throw. He's got to complete this one. Exactly what happened, but he's still down. Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. They'll run on first down with Singletary. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. It's a 6-yard gain on the ground, and that'll make it second and four. This defense, very strong in that victory from a week ago.
It was a little bit enlightening talking with the defense coordinator about their performance last week because the feeling was that it was a good, solid performance. They did what they needed to do to get the job done and get the win, but definitely a few lapses that they're looking to correct.
Second and four. Over the middle, that's caught by Kamara. And a pass midfield, just a yard or two shy of the finish.
Chicago.
And his kick is good, ready to head back on the field. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got to the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see.
A fight for it, and this is caught. What a catch. A big play that time through the air. 39 yards.
When they've needed a play this year, he's certainly been the guy to deliver it. As this season has gone on, he's been awfully consistent and sometimes spectacular.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's going to get this inside the 30. And after getting tackled, he's still down and looking very slow to get up. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. Now a play fake here on first down. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter play. After 1-7-3, the score on EA Sports. Come on.
So three plays already first and goal, and they are wasting little time. Gonna give this time to Tampa. And he's gonna take it in for a Steeler touchdown. A great play there. His fourth touchdown on the year again. And I guess the question, Charles, is what's the formula for keeping him better protected? Because as we see, the protection, it's struggled.
And normally what you get is renewed determination. When the big guy gets hit, that usually sparks people. Hey, we can't let this happen anymore. They take it personally. He's not supposed to be on the ground, but that hasn't been the case so far in this game. So maybe they've got to figure out how do they get rid of the ball faster to help out the offensive line so he doesn't get hit as much.
We'll see if they can keep him off the ground now going forward. He's upended after a gain of two out to the 27.
I know the halftime's approaching, but I don't think he's going to want to take a break. That's his big catch.
Yeah, they've really been targeting the tight end. Here's a handoff out of the gun. Rebel Street. And a shot free for about 7 up to the 35.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers are coming a little bit high. They don't have great leverage and they're easily blocked up to turn to the side.
And that was good right there because they're the bottom five in the league in converting on third down. They needed that pickup in a big way.
There were two things they said they wanted to win in this game. One, the turnover battle, and the second, third down conversions. So they got one there. From the gun, he'll hand this one, and he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
I have a feeling they'll stay committed to running the football, especially on the early downs. They just haven't had a whole lot of success just yet.
So that now four first half sacks. This pass rush has been unrelenting.
Partner, you hear that sound of paper being ripped to shreds? That's the game plan that they've had so far because they've got to say to themselves right now, we have to do something differently.
It's a 39-yard punt, three on the return. And possession will switch hands, first and 10. Getting set to go again as we look at the back heading onto the field again. And he's had his chances in this game. He just hasn't been able to find any daylight so far.
Patience, patience, patience. And that's the hard part for a runner because they expect every run to be a big one for something to pop. So they have to sometimes go through the struggles before it happens for them later in the game. But you got to give credit to the rest of the team. They've worked around the fact that he hasn't had his normal big game.
Yeah, despite his struggle, still winning here in the second quarter. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40.
I like how they worked the tight end on a nice little under route there. And if you're going to give him that much space, he's not even going to catch the football. He's going to run away from me a little bit. And that's exactly what he just did there, picking up extra yardage.
He's got the first down here inside the 30 and down to the 27-yard line. 42 yards rushing for him now, and he's carried the ball just five times. Running game working, they scored it on first down. And only a yard this time as he's taken down right around the 26. He was second and 9. Looking to throw. Looking well, and it's complete. And he's going to have another first down as the tackle's made here at the Bears 16.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage. So timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up the first down.
They should have put a stamp on
him. He's brought down just outside of the 10 at the 11. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's dropped just before the line to gain. 4-yard pickup leaves him with third and one. This will be play number 7 on the drive. Third and a yard. They'll set up to throw. From the outline, incomplete. That's Harris. And the Steelers are going to have a first and goal coming up as they find a way to convert there on third and one.
Push they needed.
Second and two. And he's got it. That one good for the completion percentage, but no gain. Third down. This Bears defense trying to hold on. This is third and goal. Now back to throw. Man, he hits it in stride. And in for the Steelers touchdown. Season, and the Steelers are going to add on to their lead. Out comes the kicking team here for the extra point. And it's 21-3. A pretty long drive that time. 11 plays all told. And it ends with a Pittsburgh touchdown. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Start at the 25 as Spencer elects not to return this. Another drive coming up for this Chicago offense. And this not an easy situation. You're down early, in the elements, you're on the road. How do you get the mojo back?
Well, one thing is to remember that as an offensive player, you have a much better idea of what you're trying to accomplish and where you're trying to go than the defender. So in this case, because you know, you can make your cuts with a little more decisiveness. Maybe a second fake, some double moves, things of that nature, to go ahead and try and put some pressure on the defense.
On first down, Singletary. And getting this just shy of midfield, spotted at the 49. He's obviously a bit of a shorter running back. And sometimes when he goes up the middle like that, he gets lost in there and then he pops out for 10, 20 yards.
I actually asked NFL linebackers if that was true. Do you actually lose sight of some of the smaller running backs? Smith, Barry Sanders, both 5'10".
On second down, here's a run with Singletary. And he'll be taken down at the 44-yard line. 4 yards on the pickup there as it'll leave it with a third and about four more for a first.
When you find that kind of yardage, you couldn't be more confident as a ball carrier. And guess what? You're going to go back and tell your offensive coordinator, I'd like to keep carrying it, thank you.
He'll look to throw. He's got the connection over the middle of the Bears. And he will have the Bears first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. They'll look to throw here on first down.
To a game plan with trying to keep a defense honest. When the guy with that type of speed, you do so. Send him deep, try and throw some air under it, and hope you connect downfield. On that play, they run successful.
This throw's going to be incomplete. So back-to-back incompletions. Third down here in 10, but you're still in field goal range.
And that's the thing to keep in mind. They're in field goal range. So now you don't take any unnecessary risks, but you try and find a way to get back to what you were doing. This has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come back and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there. And a
touchdown, Bears! Cole Kmet, his second touchdown of the season. And the Bears cut into that lead. No going for two. They'll kick the point after. single for and taken. Now we get a peek at the captain of this offense heading back out there. He's played a pretty clean first half, a touchdown, no interceptions.
Frankly, that's what they expect out of him. They want to see the ball thrown and thrown well, and he's able to do that and put it in the end zone. They'd love to see more of that before this game finishes. But right now, he's got his team in a good spot.
A good spot, maybe looking for touchdown pass number two here in the second quarter. Eluding the pressure right. His throw incomplete.
Well, you most certainly don't want to get three and out here and get the football right back, because your friend, old momentum, he's wondering if he should change sidelines about right now. And if you don't convert here, guess what? He's going to make the trip to the opposite side. And all of a sudden, you've got a battle on your hands.
And this pass broken up. And the contact well timed there. And now fourth down. Fourth down on is the punt team sending this one away. It's a 45-yard punt, just a 1-yard return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. There again is the running back as he trots onto the field. He's been good. They've utilized him well, but they're losing here in the second quarter. What might they change offensively?
I think that what you try and do is expand how you get the ball to him a little bit. Get him out in open space, maybe swing the ball to him. What's that they used to call in the West Coast offense, the long handoff?
Yeah.
Serve as your running play that way, as well as continue to feed him the football. Some of these runs now may pop bigger later in the game because of the effects of running it. Sometimes people, after a while, they don't want to tackle him anymore, or they get tired, or they get out of position, or he runs through tackles. Continue to feed him the ball. He's having that kind of game.
They get him the ball in some space in some different ways here. Now the Bears going to call the first of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go before halftime. Second and two.
Come on, baby. Let's see what you got.
They'll drop to throw. Not a full incomplete. He was held just as he let that go. And now it's third down.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
After the incompletion, here now, third and two. They're going to look to throw. This one incomplete. Probably should have been picked. A little nonchalant with the throw to the safety valve, but it's fourth down. Here's Joseph Charlton now, as he'll punt it away for the fourth time today. It'll be a 41-yard punt, given five on the return. And control of the football, switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. There he is, the man taking the snaps under center, heading out for the next possession. He's got to be feeling pretty good, playing well. Team has the lead, so just looking to mount a drive here that ends in the end zone.
And all quarterbacks will tell you, hey, we love a running game, helps us out. But at the end of the day, they want to rely on their arm. Things, keep things moving in the right direction. Right now, that's exactly what we're seeing.
And we'll see if that continues. A big connection on that one. 33 yards. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. He's going to fire one deep left sideline, and that is incomplete.
I like the thought process there. They connected on a big play, and sometimes you find the defense vulnerable. So they went for the bigger shot, went for it all on that one. This time, they were ready for it.
And this will be incomplete. 1 second left to go.
So that's one he should have held on to. But when you're playing in elements like this, sometimes those bullet passes, those ones with a little bit of pace on them, they can be difficult to hold on to.
So with 1 second left in the half, on is the field goal unit. This from 54 yards away. And his kick is right there. It's good. And that will do it for this first half. So we've reached halftime here with the visiting Steelers out in front as
Bulldogs will head down to Orlando. That's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Things definitely getting interesting around the NFL as we begin the month of December. So let's get right to it. We'll begin our trip around the NFL with an interesting one right off the bat. And it's the Bills who lead that one late in the second quarter. The Bills locked in a tight one, but this is a game you feel they've got to have. From there, let's head over to Minneapolis to check on the Vikings at home at U.S. Bank Stadium. And they trail that one over the visiting Green Bay Packers. The Packers looking to sew that one up, and they look to be in pretty good shape. Finally, let's get you to Baltimore and check on the Ravens at home at M&T Bank Stadium. And they trail in that one as it's the visiting Jags who are out in front. Trevor Lawrence with a couple of touchdown passes there. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a back-and-forth first half. Who can put it together in the second half? For the answer, we turn it back over to our broadcast team of Brandon Gott and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Forecast calling for more of the same. The rain set to continue as we are underway in the second half. A good-looking return set up here. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30, up to the 33. The Steeler offense now with the football first here to begin the third quarter. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. They'll start the third quarter here on the ground. And he will lose yardage here at the 31-yard line. 2 yards, the loss, second and 12.
That's what this defense is going to need to do more in the second half. Good pressure that time, forces some indecision in the backfield. He's going to wind up being taken down for a nice loss.
There's a quick hitch route and the throw complete. They'll get 9 there as that sets him up better for third down.
When the hitch route is run really well, that jab step off the line of scrimmage by the receiver, which is designed to back up the defender and give him a little bit of space. What you want there, get that space, catch the football, and then make a move and pick up extra yardage. And that's exactly what he got done there.
Here's a play fake as they set it up. The Bears get there. It's coming through on third down. A loss of 7 to bring up 4. The Steelers send out their punter now as he's on to kick it away. Averaging 50 yards a boot so far as this one's away. Call that a 45-yard punt, just 2 yards there on the return. And out will come the offense as they take over. Here comes the field general leading his offense back out there for the next possession. He's playing pretty well. I don't think it's necessarily him changing up something he's doing, but that O-line, they've got to protect him better.
They do. They've got to make sure that they give him more than enough time in order to find targets downfield. And sometimes what happens when these things are going on is that the field general will step up and say, hey, that's on me, guys. I didn't get rid of it fast enough. Anything to try and relax them a little bit and take some pressure off, because they do know that they are trying.
Yeah, well, we've seen the 4 sacks so far in this contest. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds.
But when you hit him on the move like that, and he's able to get an open field with a full head of steam, it's going to be tough to get him down.
Yeah, there was a big window. They're lucky they did get him down. They'll run on first down. Singletary.
Celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
They will run with Singletary. And he puts his head down and gets it to the 42 for a gain of about 6.
And there we saw all the downsides of blitzing during a rundown, because sometimes you get out of your gaps. You don't fit the run quite as well because you're headed towards the ball carrier with abandon.
Back to throw here. Complete to Moody on the slam.
This has to go down as one of the simpler routes in the Pro Bowl.
but oh so effective. Nice completion there. Keeps the sticks moving.
They'll look to throw now on first down. Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And they're coming off a three and out, my friend.
I think they got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't called before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before and realize it hasn't worked as well. And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Short, they'll try and pick it up through the air. And he fires one, but incomplete. They sure went against conventional wisdom, calling a pass on 3rd and inches.
Had to be thinking to themselves, the defense is going to overcommit against the run. Should be an easy pitch and catch. Didn't turn out that way.
They're going to try and throw. Flushed out right. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Shouts from this crowd as they watch the replays into the challenge, and they're going to get one. Did he keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was awfully close.
Yeah, it certainly looked like a heck of a catch because he didn't appear to bobble it, which could complicate things. But even with the benefit of replay, that's pretty tight.
Now, here's the call.
Review the play. Look at the field stands.
So the challenge there does not go their way. This will indeed remain a completed pass. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he's got this down almost to the 20 before he's dropped. 50 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember, last drive they went 3 and out.
Right back to him on first down. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. A lot to praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called. They are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
That is going to be taken down. Sack down. Losing 8 on the sack there, and it's second down.
The first and goal looked like things were set up nicely, and now all of a sudden on second and goal to Charles, a big challenge ahead of them.
And you have to know when you're this close to the goal line, things are going to happen faster, so you've got to get the ball out quick. Before the defenders bring pressure.
A good pickup there, 13 yards as they get closer for third down.
It's a game of matchups, and that's why you take your receivers and move them around a bunch, especially your best guys. And when they work out of the slot, you often hear the coaches talk about how great it is because it gives you a two-way go. You can break out or you can break in. That makes it hard to defend.
2 yards is all they'll get on the completion. It's fourth down. He was out there waving his arms. When you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding him.
Yes, man, it's caught for the Steelers touchdown. A great play there. His 9th touchdown of the season. And the Steelers, they broaden their lead. Through the raindrops, up and good. And the lead now to 3 touchdowns and 21. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. They will start at the 25 as Spencer elects not to return this. Here's the Chicago offense coming back out onto the field. And there are parts of their last drive they'd like to
to emulate. And, of course, they'd like to forget the inning, the interception. But they did put together, Charles, a nice sustained drive to get him down the field.
Yeah, and unfortunately for them, the only thing that matters is part two, right? Because once they threw the interception and finished off the drive, it doesn't really feel like the defense. Well, you know, get one going, finish things out. That's the only way you can get it done.
So following the incompletion here, second and 10 from the 25. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
Well, we saw a lot of negative plays that resulted in plenty of lost yardage in the first half, and that trend is continuing here.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Open man is Komet, the tight end. And they're going to get him down well short of the first as he can only get this to the 30. They get seven there, but it brings up fourth. On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. It'll be a net of 40 yards there following a 43-yard punt, 3-yard return. Pittsburgh offense making their way back out. And that last drive was very, very balanced, pretty methodical. You think they go that route again?
I'm always of the school that until they stop me from doing something, I'm going to continue. And I think that that's exactly what they'll look to do. But the beauty is the balance that they've created sets up opportunities for big plays. Looks like a run, turn into a play action, and throw one deep.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. And again, this time to the tailback. And he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of three. And guess what? It brings up third down. And he'll give it here to his running back. 2 yards on the pickup there. It's fourth down. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
And they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
Oh, and now movement and a whistle, and they may have to rethink their plans. Well, I thought they should have punted before. Now they probably definitely need to punt, right?
Yeah, we did a little mind melding there, didn't we? Because I was wondering, why are you out there if you're not going to punt it in the first place? Now, I don't think they have any choice.
So they're forced to punt on fourth as this one's away. Good coverage there holds him to just a 2-yard return following a punt of 44. And now Chicago getting ready to go as they take the field. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when a pitcher gets a base hit and is on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times, the punter gives us all that, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep him warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
Here comes the blitz as they look to throw. And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40.
You can see the time and effort and thought that they put into their passing game because it was evident right there. It looks like a simple pitch and catch. But you and I both know that they have planned for this and worked hard to make it happen.
And he'll work this forward for about three. It's second down. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven.
You can't block me. You can't block me.
He'll drop to throw. He'll get that complete to his tight end Komet. They'll wind up getting seven on the play. And that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. They'll try to run for this with Singletary. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line.
Bring it up, bring it up.
Back now at Soldier Field. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL. And it's a ball that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. Picked off here, the 32. And they will finally stop him, but a great return. Gets that football all the way down to the 16-yard line. That intercepted. interception may be the exclamation mark on what really all around has been a good performance.
A fantastic performance. They will enjoy film session. Their grade should be very good on this one. And I think the next time the offense gets the ball, I just think about running it and getting the clock done and getting home.
That is ripped up. Taken down. Back of the 25. That will set up back nearly 10 yards here on first down on the sack. Off the play fake. He'll look to throw. Going for it all. And it is incomplete. I had a defender running right with him. And now it's third down. And he'll run on the inside handoff. And he's going to come up well short as they rally up to stop him at about the 16. Give him 9 on the carry, but it's not enough. And it'll be fourth down. This one is right through, and that will extend the lead out to 24. So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field goal there.
And what a luxury it is to have a kicker you can depend upon, partner, because he hasn't missed all year long. Converts on that one as well, and kudos to you. You didn't jinx it.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Chicago offense set to get started. Well, I think that the folks here had hoped that maybe this home atmosphere would carry their guys to a surprise victory, but it does not appear that that's going to be the case. There's too much to handle on the other side in this one. Looking right sideline, but it's incomplete. Following the incomplete pass, here they go again, second and 10 from the 25.
From working his way into the secondary, figures out defenses and finds weak spots in order to get open.
They should have put a stamp on him.
Getting his inside the 25.
This game was decided a while ago. That completion there is going to artificially inflate his passing numbers. So right now, the only one really applauding probably his agent as he thinks about angling for a new contract.
Defensively, they've had their way in this one. That pick six makes that scoreboard even more lopsided.
I remember talking with a guy in the league, and I said, what do you do when the game's like this? You know, it's pretty much over. You ready to go to the bench and hang out? He said, oh, heck no. I want to stay on the field. I might get some stats. I might get a pick or two.
You like being out there at the end of these wide margins.
When they have to throw it, that gives you more opportunities to go get it.
After right down the middle, and that will extend this big lead. So they throw the pick six. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
The
Bears offense out there, set and ready to go. And just looking ahead, it would appear that that bye week is coming at the right time. They'll have 2 weeks to chew on this one, though probably not one that they want to chew on. A poor performance from start to finish. After the pick six, they go right back to the Bears. He's going to be dropped following a pickup of seven, past the 30 to the 32. One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. They're tackling them almost on the spot. That means they have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
This one complete on the snap. In this second half. Here's first and 10. Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. They'll look to throw again. And that'll be incomplete. Well, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down.
Tell you what, partner, after he ices down, he's going to be a nice long soak in a hot tub after this one. He's been under duress the entire game.
And once again, hit as he throws. Fortunate that one wound up incomplete. Back to throw again. Blitz coming, and down he goes. T.J. Watt in there to get him, and on the season now, that is 9 sacks for him.
We've been around this league for a while, and many coaches never pull their starting quarterback, almost no matter the situation. In this case, though, I think he's got to make a decision. He's taking a pretty good beating out there.
Yeah, and with the deficit, maybe not wanting to risk an injury. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off at the 49. And he brings this one back. It's a pick six. For a Steeler touchdown. To try here for the extra point. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. So the defense creating some points, not only getting the interception, but then returning it to the end zone for the pick six. So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six, and now the kick is away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. Another drive coming up for this Chicago offense. It's now appearing that this losing streak is going to continue. You know, the coaching staff was confident that this was going to be the game to stem the tide, but that just has not been the case. They'll come out throwing here on first down. Throwing into traffic there, and that's complete. And he's upended at the 33, following a good pickup of 8.
Nothing fancy on first down, but a very consistent tempo of play. Hit that slant. A lot of people call it an extension of the running game, and it can be if that pass is completed. Because you hit a guy to run like that, you're
looking for the edge. Sets him up nicely for second down, still on the
certainly pretty well over. They go ahead and mark it in the win column. But as a defense, they don't want to get so soft now that everybody just throws the ball all over the place against them, gets big yardage, and puts points on the board. They have pride, too, on that side of the field.
Third.
Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long.
Let's get it together, defense. Let's get it together.
Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. Gets this only to the 44-yard line. Not near enough to keep the drive alive. They do get 10 back, but still a ways to go on fourth. Here comes the Bears punter now, as they're forced to kick for the sixth time today. This is fielded at the 7. That'll go as a punt of 34 yards that time. Pittsburgh getting set to take the field. And they just continue to roll right along, really. This has the looks of yet another victory as they hope to polish it off here in quarter number 4. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 73 yards rushing for him now on what was his 10th carry of the ball game. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. That is going to bring us to the 2-minute warning. So the Steelers with a football as we get you reset. They've got a second down now as they look to salt this one away. And he'll be brought down just shy of the 45. Call it a gain of 5 there on the run, but they'll remain a yard or two short here with third down coming up. And again this time to the tailback. Midfield just a yard or two shy of the 40.
The carries like that, that's how they're going to continue to salt this thing away here, Charles, in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, how about that? A new set of downs. Clock continues to move. No better
way. Close. And this is picked up by the Bears. And they will set up sharp at their own 41-yard line. And maybe that one caused by the weather. Of course, the rain coming down. Charles, can you maybe, when you're carrying that football, grip it too tight in the rain?
I think that you can, and it's such a delicate balance, too, because when you grip it so tight, sometimes it'll slip out from your body. You squeeze it too hard, and it'll pop out on its own. I've actually had running backs talk to me about that, that when they've tried too hard, even in perfect conditions, the ball gets away from them.
Maybe try to get a jump start on that route.
Yeah, I think you're exactly right about that, and oftentimes when you see that, that means the play call was supposed to come in his direction, and he was eager to go catch a pass.
He's going to let it fly. And that will be incomplete as time has run out on this football game. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory, and the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week. We'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points. Allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for the Steelers, they continue to keep pace for that first round bye as they move to 11-1. And they'll have another road date next week with the Cincinnati Bengals. Meanwhile, for the Bears, they're squarely in play for next year mode now as they drop to 2-11. And they'll get the extra week to think about this one as they return to action in 2 weeks' time. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports.